It's so hot.
Whew! And the sun is so bright.
Why is it so hot today?
Who do we ask for help when we have questions?
Da 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 da! Maggie the magnifying glass!
I'm Maggie, Maggie. I help to make things clear. Just look through my looking glass and answers will appear. I'm Maggie, Maggie. Come and let's explore, and we'll discover lots of things you never knew before. I'm Maggie!
Why is it so hot today? It's because of the sun and how the sunlight is hitting the Earth. The sun is a star, closer to Earth than any other star in the universe. Would you like to learn more about the sun? If so, we can go on a little adventure together.
Would you like to learn about the sun too?
You would?
Me too!
Yippee Skippy, let's go!
Don't forget your journal!
Oh yeah, got it! My terrific scientific journal! Bring yours along too!
Let's take a look at the sun!
What is the sun?
The sun is made up of burning gases. The sun burns hundreds of tons of gases every second. Here are some fun sun facts. The surface of the sun is almost 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit. That's incredibly hot. The sun is 4.5 billion years old. The sun is 93 million miles away from Earth. It would take a car driving at 65 miles per hour about 164 years to reach the sun.
Wow! How long does it take for sunlight to reach the Earth?
Great question. It takes sunlight just a little over 8 minutes to reach the Earth. The sun is so important to us here on Earth that without it, life would not exist.
I'm gonna write that down in my journal. So the sun is a star. It's made up of burning gas. And it takes sunlight over 8 minutes to travel to Earth. Got it.
The sun and the seasons. The sun heats the Earth. But why is it hot in the summer and cold in the winter?
I was wondering the same thing.
Excellent question. To best understand, we have to take a look at our solar system. The sun is part of our solar system. The Earth and 7 other planets and moons, comets, asteroids, dust, and gas move around the sun. And the sun is the largest object in our solar system. Just like everything else in our solar system, the Earth travels or orbits around the sun. It takes the Earth 365 days, or one whole year, to orbit one time around the sun. In that 1 year, the seasons and the weather change many times. The sun controls the weather and 4 seasons on Earth. The 4 seasons are summer, spring, winter, and fall. To understand how it works, you have to know a little bit more about the Earth. At the top of the Earth is the North Pole. At the bottom of the Earth is the South Pole. There is an imaginary line called the axis that goes from the North Pole through the Earth to the South Pole. The Earth spins or rotates on its axis. In the middle of the Earth, there is another imaginary line called the equator. The equator divides the Earth into 2 halves, called the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere. However, the Earth is slightly tilted. When the North Pole is tilted towards the sun, it's summer in the northern hemisphere of the Earth. It takes in more sunlight. With more light, the days are longer, and the weather is warmer. It's summer. At the same time, the South Pole is tilted away from the sun. The southern hemisphere receives less sun. It's winter. With less sun, the days become shorter and weather is colder. When the South Pole is tilted towards the sun, it's summer in the southern hemisphere and winter in the northern hemisphere. So, it's the sun and the tilt of the Earth that cause the different seasons throughout the year. The equator is always facing the sun directly. This is why places around the equator never get very cold. The further away from the equator you get, the colder it gets.
Oh, I get it. The part of the Earth that is tilted towards the sun gets more sunlight, and that makes it summer. Got it! The sun and the weather.
The sun plays an important role in affecting weather on Earth, including wind, rain, clouds, and more. Here's how. The sun heats up the Earth's surface. That warms up the air in the atmosphere. Warm air weighs less than cool air. The warm air rises or moves up. When the warm air moves up, it leaves an area of low pressure. Then the cool air, which weighs more than the warm air, sinks or moves down and replaces the warm air. Now, as the warm air moves up, it cools off, then begins to sink. This movement of air, warm air rising, cool air sinking, is what makes the wind blow. Wind is a big part of our weather. The sun also heats up the water in the oceans, lakes, and rivers, causing the water to evaporate or turn to steam or vapor. The vapor then travels up into the sky. This vapor cools and comes together, collecting in clouds. If there is enough water in the clouds, it will fall to the earth as rain or snow. Some of this rain will collect in the ground, and some will fall in rivers until it makes its way back to the ocean to begin the cycle over again. It's called the water cycle, and it's very important to every living thing on Earth, and it affects weather all over the world. To predict weather, it's important for meteorologists, or scientists who study weather, to know the temperature of the air. Temperature is the hotness or coldness of something. People use thermometers to measure temperature. Temperature is measured in degrees. An old-fashioned thermometer uses liquid mercury, or another kind of liquid, in a glass tube with a bulb at the bottom. As it gets hotter, the liquid heats up. The molecules in the liquid begin to move and take up more space. When they don't fit in the bulb anymore, the liquid moves up the tube. The numbers on the side of the tube are used to measure how far up the liquid rises. People use different scales to measure temperature. This thermometer measures on Fahrenheit scale and the Celsius scale. You'll see that 32 degrees Fahrenheit, the temperature at which water freezes, is the same as 0 degrees Celsius.
The sun's rays. It's noontime, and it seems hotter now than it was before. How come?
Good question. Do you know why?
As the Earth spins, the sun appears to move across the sky. When it's directly above you, around noontime, it is hotter than at the end of the day, when the sun is setting. Every living thing on Earth, animals, people, and plants need the sun to live. But too much sun can be dangerous. The sun radiates light to the Earth. And part of that light consists of invisible ultraviolet UV rays. When these rays reach the skin, they cause tanning, burning, and other skin damage.
What can you do to protect yourself?
Well, the sun is highest and strongest between 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. If you're outside during this time, it's important to protect your skin by putting on sunscreen. You can also stay in shaded areas and out of direct sunlight. The sun can also damage your eyes. You can protect your eyes by wearing sunglasses.
Today I learned a lot about the sun. I hope you did too. These are the notes I took in my journal. The sun is part of our solar system, and the Earth orbits around the sun. The sun also affects the seasons and weather on Earth. We all need the sun to live, but too much sun can be dangerous. Learning about the sun and heat was fun. Let's go on another scientific adventure real soon. Bye.
So long.